But from these very specific applications, I would like to move on to two others, which are very different and, in a certain sense, perhaps far more surprising and, to me, very exciting. One of them is simply the beauty of fractals. The fact that they're beautiful and that they are inspired, for example, musicians to better understand their craft. Music consists in creating very complicated systems of sounds. Great musicians have confided to me that their schools never taught them how to distinguish music from noise. They had many rules, but the rules were not sufficient to characterize music. Upon learning of fractals, they realized, as others had realized independently by more mundane techniques, that music of every culture, of every period, is invariably fractal, a one-over-f noise. A music which is not fractal is not perceived as beautiful. What does fractal mean in this case? That the structures in the large scale, the middle scale, and the small scale are in balance with each other. It is not the case that there is a very large scale variation with nothing of small scale superposed on it, or the converse. That is an element of balance which is implied in beauty, which actually has been implied very strongly since times of the 6th century before Christ, that beauty consists in harmony of the parts. This element is present completely in fractals, and by people who are not themselves artists, is perceived as an element of attractiveness in aesthetic sense. This has led many of my friends to question again givens about what is beauty, what is decoration, what is the share of the intent, what is share of the personality of the artist, and what is share of simple structural rules in this problem. This applies also to architecture to a large extent, but it would be too long to explain it.